If you enter digital competitions, the chances are you'll be asked to send your image at an exact size. Now, there are lots of different ways of doing that, but I'm going to show you a way that works both for Photoshop and for Elements, and is reasonably easy to do. It involves using the crop tool. So let's get the crop tool from the toolbar, and then up here on the options, we're going to put some dimensions in. Now, a standard size for competitions is 1024 by 768 pixels. So let's type that in, width of 1024, then a space, and px for pixels. The height, we're going to put in as 768, then a space, px for pixels. The resolution actually doesn't matter, but if you want to put something in there, put 72, that's fine. Okay, we need to set our background colour to black. At the moment it isn't, so we'll reset the colours by clicking the mini black and white squares, and then the curly arrow to rotate the colours over, and now we have black as our background colour. Now that seems a bit of an odd thing to do, but that's quite an important step, don't miss that out. Finally, we're going to zoom out a wee bit. Let's get the zoom tool, hold the Alt key, and just zoom out so we've got a bit of working area around our picture. Okay, back to the crop tool. I'm going to make a crop from outside the top left and go all the way down to the bottom right corner. Except I won't be able to get to the bottom right corner. Because we've put some dimensions, it'll only make a crop of the proportions that we entered, 1024, 768. And the chances are that won't cover the whole of your picture. Mine's missing a big block on the right-hand side. Not to worry, just click in one of the corner handles and drag it up and out until you get the whole picture selected. There we go. It's a little bit too much at the top, so I want to center this up, and we'll just drag this down like so. Now, if you're doing a portrait format, of course, these extra bits will be on the sides rather than top and bottom, but the principle is exactly the same. Okay, so there we are, that's pretty much in the middle. When you're happy, click the tick, and that'll crop the image down. Okay, not only has it cropped it, but where we had those extra areas, it's filled it with black. Remember, we set the background colour. And that means that that won't be projected. Black is black, and of course won't be projected. It'll be just a black screen. But your image should now be image size 1024 at 768 pixels. Perfect. It might be worth just checking the sharpness of the picture. Filter, sharpen, unsharp mask. Sometimes when you downsize a picture, you can lose a little bit of the clarity. Not always, but just sometimes. It's worth just having a close look and sharpening it up if it requires it. Okay, all you need to do now is to save this. We'll go to File, choose Save As. Here we go. And we can save it. Save it as a copy, don't save the original. Now, some competitions ask for you to save it as a specific file name. Now's the chance to do that. For example, some competitions I enter ask for the title to be in capitals. Spooky Street. Oops, can't type. There we go. Then a space, then lowercase, then the word by, then another space, and then your name, Gavin Howie. But different competitions will have different rules. Just make sure you get it absolutely exact. And then click Save. Save it at whatever size you need to. Again, some competitions will specify a maximum image size, which you'll see over here. For example, this image, if I saved it now, would be 246.8K. If that's too big, you can drop the file size down. So the quality at 7, it's now 126. So basically save it at the maximum quality you can, as long as it meets the criteria of your competition. Click OK, and that image is now ready to go off for competition.